In this video, I will show you how to average numbers by weekday with and without a helper column in Excel like this. So let's get started. I have some transactions with dates and amounts in this Excel sheet. Now I want to calculate the average amount by day of the week like Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, etc. For example, I want to average these two amounts for Friday, and I want to get the average of these three amounts for Saturday. We can use the Excel AVERAGEIF function to average numbers by day of the week. I already have the date of the transactions in this column. So first, I will convert these dates to day names using the Excel text function. The text function, as the name suggests, converts a number to text in the specified format. This function accepts two arguments, a number to convert to text and the format of the output. There are a variety of formats to choose from, but for this particular case, we can use the format DDDD to convert a date to a day name. For example, this text formula will return Sunday by converting the date 1st December 2024, and this text formula will return the text Thursday by converting the date 12th December 2024. We can also use the DDD format instead of the DDDD format to convert a date to a short day name like MON, TUE, etc. instead of the full day name. Once we get the day name from the date, I will compare it with the day name stored in the E column. If the dates match, I want to average the amount. Let's start the formula by typing an equal sign in the target cell. Now type AVERAGEIF followed by an opening bracket. Since we want to compare the day names, let's select the day name cells as the first argument. Type a comma and then select the cell containing the day name as the second criteria argument. We want to average the amount if the day matches, so let's select the range of the cells containing the amount as the third average range argument. Type the closing bracket of the AVERAGEIF function. I will also make the day name and amount range references absolute using the dollar signs like this so that they do not change when I drag the formula to other cells. Hit the enter key to complete the formula. Copy the formula to other cells by dragging the cell down from the bottom right corner of the cell. As you can see, we now have the average amount by day of the week. For this approach, I am going to use the average, if, and text functions. Here is the formula to do that. Here, the text function converts the dates to day names using the DDDD format and returns the result as an array. The if function then compares the elements with the text Friday and again returns an array as the result of the comparison. Here, true means the cell contains the date of Friday and false for any other weekday. The if function returns an amount cell for every true value and an empty string is returned for every false value. As you can see, only element 3 and 5 are having respective amount values because date 3 and 5 are of Friday, while the rest of the elements contain an empty string value. This array is passed as an argument of the average function, which discards the empty string values and calculates the average of these two numbers, which is 15. Since this is an array formula, we need to enter it using the Ctrl, Shift and Enter keys. As you can see, we now have an average of the numbers for Friday. A similar formula has been used for the Saturday and Sunday to calculate the average of numbers by day name. Watch these videos for more Excel tips, tricks and how-to tutorials. If you found this video helpful, please like the video and subscribe to our channel.